Good morning, YouTube. I've been trying to figure out what I wanted to do with the condensate drain on my tankless water heater. So here's a few options that I found on Amazon here. This is a ream hose kit here. If we scroll up, you can see it's a replacement condensate drain. And it's basically just a lengths of clear tubing. Back down here, we can see here's the tubing. And then I guess this is designed to go off of one of these vertical concentric vents, as they call it. So you can see here, this is a double wall tube. There's a inner tube here that is for the fresh air coming in. And then on the outside is where the exhaust gas goes up. And then here on the side is a little fitting where you collect the water vapor that condenses out of the exhaust gas, and then you run it through that tube and down to some sort of drain to get rid of it. And a lot of these tankless water heaters, this is a Renai, are set up for these concentric vents. They just have a single exhaust and intake port on the top, and then you set one of these vertical sections on top, or they also make ones with a right angle and a horizontal tube to go off of there. That's how a lot of these drain kits are set up. And just to show you here, this is a slightly different concentric vent. This one would be for a heater similar to mine. It's set up for 3-inch PVC. You've got the intake over here, and then the exhaust comes in here at a 45 degree angle on the side, and then you would add another 45 and then come down here to the exhaust port here, and then the separate intake port. Okay, and one question that might need to be answered is right here. This is on Google Answers. It says, how many pounds of water is released when burning 100,000 BTUs of natural gas, or one therm, basically? Anyway, this fellow, back about 14 years ago, he went through a bunch of calculations down here, and we'll skip down here. He actually had the math error in the initial answer there. But if we come down here, basically it comes out to about 8 pounds of water for one therm, or 100,000 BTUs, or 100 cubic feet of natural gas. So you're looking at roughly a gallon of water if you were to condense every single molecule of water out of the exhaust gas. Of course, exhaust gas going up the stack is probably still at or above the temperature of your hot water. There's probably still quite a bit of humidity and water going up the stack, so you're not going to see that full gallon of water in terms of condensation, but you'll see, you know, a fair bit of it. And then it's also going to depend on how much humidity was in the incoming air and the temperature and all that. But roughly a gallon or 4 liters of water from 100,000 BTUs. And on my heater, that's about the maximum burn rate, is about 100,000 BTUs per hour. So I would see at the most 1 gallon of water condensing out of the exhaust in an hour of operation. And just to put that in perspective, so far my heater has been averaging about 1 therm of gas in a month. So we're talking about 1 gallon of water flowing through the drain over a period of a month. It's not 1 gallon all at once. So it's not a huge volume of water, but it's not insignificant either. So we can go take a look at that. Okay, YouTube, so this is what I'm looking at on my Takagi water heater. Right here, where I'm pointing to, is the condensate drain port. So this heater collects the condensate inside of the heater itself, and there's a threaded pipe fitting there, and this is my washing machine drain pipe. It's basically a stand pipe that goes down to a P-trap down at floor level. So there's about 3 feet of vertical pipe here that's open, and this is the washing machine drain right there, and there's just enough room in that inch and a half ABS drain pipe to slip in a 3/8 inch clear PVC drain tube, and I think that's about all I need. I just have that pipe, but it's just a little length of pipe. I just have it shoved in there. There's a, like a little groove in the side of the washing machine drain that I slipped the clear PVC in. I just had to come up with a way to go from the male thread on the bottom of the water heater to a hose barb fitting. Anyway, I thought as a first test, just to see if this works, this was a compression nut from a shutoff valve for a faucet. So it's got the half inch pipe thread inside and was made out of brass. And I had a hose barb fitting this, and I found they made a perfect fit there. So I just wire brushed the brass and put a little flux and got my propane torch and soldered the two together. And I figure I would just use this as a proof of concept to see if this works. And I'll show you later in the video, this seems to be adequate for just moving the condensate from right there to right there. And this is PVC clear vinyl tubing, and that's what the manufacturer recommends. They have PVC, or I think they have another kind of drain material. First, I figured I'd do this because I had these parts around. The only slight concern is that the condensate is slightly acidic. They say it's about equivalent of lemon juice, so there might be some problem with the brass being attacked by the condensate. So I figure I'll keep an eye on this. I've been using this for 2.5 months and it still looks pretty much like I put it up there, so I figure I'll keep an eye on this, maybe check it once a year and see if anything's going on. If that material proves to be a problem. So I've got a plastic hose barb fitting here. I'll have to buy a couple of adapters to get this up to the pipe thread that fits on the bottom of the heater. So if it proves to be a problem, I'll switch to plastic. But anyway, let's put this back together and then I'll show you how this works in action. Yeah, so there you can see the condensate drain working. Yeah, we get a few drops every second or two. And right now, let's see, we're running at, get that in the camera there, 2.7 gallons a minute. And let's see, incoming is 75, and I think 120 on the outlet. Yeah, 120. So this is the clothes washer running. Yeah, we're getting pretty good. Pretty good flow in the condensate. That's why I put the clear tube on there so I can keep an eye on it. If you see the water backing up, that would say that something is clogged up in the drain pipe there. Yeah, that comes out pretty steady. Yeah, it's not quite a steady stream. It still comes out as drops, but that tube is more than able to pass that amount of water. A couple drops a second there at the most. But yeah, I think that's working out okay. Yeah, so there are the, you can see it shuts off instantly as soon as the clothes washer flow stops, the heater goes into standby mode, and then the condensate drain stops flowing because there's no more gas being burned. Yeah, it's just barely warm to the touch there. It's not hot. I mean, the hot water is hot, but the condensate drain is just about skin temperature there. So I still need to redo the drain a little bit because I got to plumb in a drain pipe for my sink over here. So that's
still needs to be done. So actually I'll be moving the drain pipe over just a little bit. I've moved the pressure relief drain here, the TPR drain, over, and then I'll be moving the laundry drain over just a little bit, just to get it closer to the sink on the other side there. But yeah, that's working out pretty good. So I'll show you the rest of this when I get the laundry done here, so it's not so noisy.